primary school aged children could be eligible for a Pfizer vaccine by the end of next month. The Therapeutic Goods Administration is now looking at new data of trials of vaccines on children aged between 5 and 11 years old and expects to approve it come November.
Application, again, this is public knowledge, for the children is for a third of a dose, because they believe once you're under 11, a third of a dose is just as good as, so it's 10 micrograms rather than 30 micrograms.
It follows a major development in the United States, where the drug regulator has endorsed the vaccine for children in the same age group. Amelia Adams has the story.
Well, this is a significant step for America's pandemic response. A health advisory board today unanimously endorsing Pfizer's jab for primary school-aged children. It's the same vaccine adults receive, but one third of the dose. So two shots, 21 days apart. Studies show it's 91% effective in preventing infection in that age group. But it was a fairly heated debate leading up to today's vote. Several doctors and other experts expressing concerns about side effects for children, including myocarditis. That's a heart inflammation condition which has been presenting mainly in young men after their second Pfizer jab.
And we really need to see what the long-term outcomes for these kids will be. So far, the data for follow-up results is sparse.
Others argued the vaccine simply isn't necessary for children that young because the risk of serious illness from COVID in that age group is so low.
For perspective, children in this age group were about 10 times more likely to die from suicide than from COVID-19.
Regardless, the US drug regulator ruled the benefits outweigh the risks. The Centers for Disease Prevention and Control now has to sign off on the jab. Then shots could be going into arms as early as next week. But it's a highly divisive issue here. About a third of parents of children in that age group have already said they won't be rushing out to get their child vaccinated. And it will be up to individual states and school districts to decide whether to mandate the vaccine.